Hey there, I'm Captain Samer Abdel, and I'm a pilot here at JetBlue. And welcome to JetBlue Junior. Have you ever wondered how airplanes stay up in the sky? They're very heavy. Did you know that the average JetBlue aircraft can weigh up to 500 tons? That's about 250 cars. That's a lot of cars. So how can something that heavy fly through the air? Let's talk about it. For this exercise, we're gonna need an 8x11 piece of paper. That's the same paper that you find in your printer. We're gonna need a pen or a pencil, and we're gonna need an open area in your house where we don't have to worry about hitting anything.
Okay, let's start by folding our paper in half, hot dog style. Next, we're going to fold these two little corners down. Great. Now take the new corner and fold it over the long side of the paper. And then do the same thing on the other side. Now let's fold our plane wings in half one more time. And finally, fold open the wings just a bit. Okay, you should now have a paper airplane ready for takeoff. Here at JetBlue, we like to name all of our planes. Most of the time, our names include the word blue. I'm going to name this one, Simon Says, Fly JetBlue. Why don't you grab a pencil and name yours too? Now it's time to test our plane out. First, make sure no one is in the way of your flight path. Pull your arm back and let go.
All airplanes rely on the same exact forces that your paper airplane just did to fly. Anytime an aircraft is in the air, there are four forces that are acting on that aircraft at the same time. Gravity, lift, thrust, and drag. When a plane flies, it's designed to use or limit the effects of those four forces. The first force I mentioned, you might have heard of already, gravity. Gravity is a force that pulls objects down. Everything on Earth is affected by the planet's gravitational pull. If you put your airplane on the ground, it won't move. And if you push your airplane off the edge of the table, it'll fall down. In order for us to get this airplane up in the air, we have to create a force opposite of gravity to lift us up in the air. And that's where lift comes in. You may have never heard of lift before, but you may have already experienced it. Have you ever held your hand outside the window of a car while driving? If you curve your hand up slightly, the air might feel like it's lifting your hand up. Now, how do we create lift? As air passes over the wing, it goes faster on top of the wing and slower at the bottom of the wing. That creates a difference of pressure. Underneath the wing, we're gonna have a high pressure area, and above the wing, we're gonna have a low pressure area. Everything wants to go from high to low. So this high pressure wants to push up towards the low pressure, and that's how lift is created.
The next
force that airplanes use to fly is something called thrust. Thrust just means a force or a push. When you throw your paper airplane across the room, you are the source of thrust. In modern airplanes, the jet engines are the high-powered pushing machines. Air gets in and sucked into the engines where it gets squeezed, or what they call compressed. This means that the air is bunched together. From there, fuel is fed into the engine, which causes the air to expand and explode out of the back of the engine. Think about a balloon. When you fill a balloon up with air and let it go, it'll fly around the room thanks to the thrust it's created by the force of the escaping air. Well, jet engines work the same way. Even with the right amount of lift and thrust, there's still another factor that we have to deal with which counteracts thrust: drag. Drag is the force that holds things back. The faster an object is going through the air, the more resistance it will run into. If you've ever run fast enough to feel the wind on your face, you've experienced a mild form of drag yourself. All modern airplanes are designed to try to minimize the drag as much as possible, and that's why airplanes have pointed noses. Notice your paper airplane also has a pointed nose. Now, if we gave them square noses, we'd need a lot more thrust to cut through the air. As the name suggests, drag can be a real drag sometimes. So let's review to see if everybody understood me. There are four forces acting on an aircraft at any given time while it's in the air. There's gravity that's trying to pull us to the ground, yet we counteract that with lift. We have thrust that pushes us forward through the air, and then we have drag that's trying to counteract that force of thrust. Our job as pilots is to actually manage these forces during the flight in order to achieve the desired trajectory. In other words, if we want to go faster, then we just increase thrust, and it counteracts the drag that is met, and the aircraft flies faster. If we want to slow down the aircraft, then we just pull the thrust back, drag overcomes it, and it slows the aircraft down. If we want to climb up, we actually increase the wind over the wing, and it creates more lift, and the airplane goes up. But if we want to descend down, then we actually decrease the amount of wind that's passing over the wing, therefore decreasing the lift and letting gravity slowly pulling us down towards the ground. Thank you for joining me and happy flying. I'm Captain Samer Abdel, and from all of us at JetBlue, hope to see you in the air sometime soon.